And I'm back with John Banville. We're talking about the new novel, The Black-Eyed Blond. I want to pick up on something we were just talking about the differences in writing the crime fiction as Benjamin Black and your other work. Are you always working on both at the same time, or does one necessitate sort of...
No, I tried when I started to be Benjamin Black. I tried to be Black in the morning and Banville in the afternoon. It didn't work.
That's impossible. To be two people?
I couldn't slip from one persona to the other. So what I do is, I'm always working on a John Banville book. Mm-hmm. John Banville book takes 2 to 5 years. So I put that aside and I write a Benjamin Black book, usually over the summer, because I hate the summer. I find it the most boring season of all. And writing a Benjamin Black book is a great excuse for not being dragged out to the beach or to go for walks or any of that stuff. I get through the summer by being Black.
Did you start the pseudonym for a particular reason? I never understood that. I mean, was it to hide what you were doing, in a sense?
No, not at all. Yeah. I never intended to hide behind the pseudonym. I took a pen name because I wanted my Banville readers to realize this was something genuine I was doing. I wasn't playing a postmodernist literary trick. Mm-hmm. That this was a new adventure I was embarking on. I was turning 60 when I invented Benjamin Black. I went off on a frolic of my own. Mm-hmm. I've been enjoying it ever since.
And since I have you here, it's a chance to sort of ask about the bigger question about the state of fiction today, especially coming from Ireland, from a non-U.S. perspective. What do you see when you look at contemporary fiction?
Well, contemporary fiction is very strong in America still. Mm-hmm. But you have the great advantage here that modernism never really reached the shores of America. And the great 19th century novel is still being written in America.
Mm-hmm. Still being written?
Yes, mm-hmm. And it's all better for that. The American novel didn't lose its confidence, which the European novel did. Everybody, under the influence of Ulysses and then Beckett and people... said, what's the point of writing fiction anymore? America never had that crisis of conscience.
So it was the Irish novelists who killed it, to the Irish writers?
Not just the Irish writers. Uh-huh. Joyce certainly contributed to it, but, your own Ford Madox Ford and people like that. Mm-hmm. That whole modernist trend was away from believing in the illusion. But there was another direction in modernism, which was Henry James. I mean, I regard Henry James as the first great real modernist with a lowercase m. Mm-hmm. But people didn't follow him. Mm-hmm. But I find that Henry James, for instance, Henry James's stream of consciousness, a term that Joyce took over, but it was invented by Henry James's brother William. And Henry James gets closer to what it is like to be conscious in the world than I think Joyce does or any of the modernists did.
And do you find a place for that still in the, one of the things we look at, talk about a lot is the technology making people read less and less of a place for serious fiction?
Well, now, how long have we got? You want to talk about technology. You said people read less. They don't. Mm-hmm. People read more. People are constantly reading. When the iPhone came in, I didn't know what it was. Yeah. And I would see people on buses and trains going... And I said to someone, what are they doing? He said, they're reading. Mm-hmm. They're reading. Umberto Eco said that in the 70s and the early 80s, it looked as if Western culture was going to become completely image-based. It would all be screens with pictures on them.
Right.
Then information technology came in. Now mm-hmm. everybody is reading. Everybody's reading. And, it doesn't matter what they're reading. People complain about... 50 Shades of Grey or whatever. What does it matter? We're so used to this miraculous process that we don't notice it anymore. Mm-hmm. But turning black marks on a white page into images, ideas, visions in our imaginations, that is an extraordinary process. And who cares if it's bad stuff they're reading? They're still doing that extraordinary transmutation of black marks on a white page into images, into thoughts, into ideas. It's wonderful. And thank goodness it's happening. I don't care whether it's on an iPhone mm-hmm. or whether it's 50 Shades of Grey or, John Banville's High Literature. I don't care what it is. Let people keep reading because that stimulates the imagination.
All right. John Banville, thank you very much.
Thank you.